Hey mamas, pregnancy and birth come with a lot of questions, especially for the first-time mama. And since knowledge is power, it's so important to have an answer to those questions. Not only does it help you have peace of mind, which can also help you have a peaceful body, but it can also help you make quality decisions for yourself and for your baby. So in this video, I'm going to be answering three frequently asked questions that you mamas have been asking me. I'm Bridget, and I'm a birth doula and a childbirth educator in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I love helping mamas understand and trust that their bodies are built to give birth. If you're new to this channel and want to feel empowered from pregnancy to motherhood, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the little bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. Getting your questions answered is such an important part of preparing for birth because it helps you process through uncertainties and unknowns to help you feel secure in what's to come. So by the end of this video, whether you're asking these questions now or will be down the road, you'll have three more answers to help you prepare for what's happening now or may happen in the future. So the first question is, what is lightning crotch? I've had so many mamas ask me about this shooting pain in their vaginas, typically toward the end of their pregnancy. They're wondering if they're contractions or if it's a sign that they're dilating or if the sensation is even normal at all. So let's talk about it right here and right now. Lightning crotch feels a lot like it sounds. It's an abrupt, sharp, shocking sensation that is usually felt in the vagina mostly, and then in the pelvis, sometimes in the butt, and at times down the thighs as well. And what's causing this sensation is usually baby's head that is applying a lot of pressure on your cervix. Now, your cervix is part of the uterus, which is a muscular organ that surrounds your growing baby. And a lot of the nerves in the uterus are located right by your cervix. So as baby is getting closer to being born and is gauging lower into the pelvis and putting lots of pressure on that cervix, you might feel those shocking lightning-like sensations. These sensations might happen more when you make an abrupt movement, like standing up really quickly or changing directions when you're walking or sitting up too quickly from a lying down position. You also might notice that you get that lightning crotch when your baby stretches or kicks or changes positions inside your belly. All these things may cause your ligaments surrounding your pelvis to be pulled or your baby to apply more pressure on the cervix, and that can often result in experiencing lightning crotch. Now, typically, lightning crotch becomes more obvious the closer you get to your baby's birth. And so because of that, it can sometimes make mamas wonder if they are contractions, but they are not. Contractions feel a lot more like tightening, pressure, and cramping than that sharp shooting feeling that lightning crotch brings. So while they aren't contractions, it doesn't mean that nothing is happening down there. Because lightning crotch usually indicates baby's head is putting pressure on your cervix, it could mean that baby is applying enough pressure to help you begin to dilate. Now, this doesn't mean that if you are experiencing lightning crotch that this is definitely true or that you're going to be in labor super soon. It just means that your baby is in a position that is allowing them to put adequate, although uncomfortable, pressure on your cervix that needs to open to allow baby to come through it. So while lightning crotch is normal and fairly common, it's always worth opening up to your doctor about it so that they are fully aware of how to best support you, and they may even be able to give you tips on how to ease the discomfort of the sensations. Now for mamas who are experiencing lightning crotch, using a belly band that supports your growing belly and relieves some of that pressure that's being put on your nerves and ligaments can really help a lot, and I will link one down below that you can get for yourself. Another way to manage lightning crotch is to exercise regularly and to practice positions and movements that promote balance and openness in your pelvis. So walking helps promote that balance and openness, as well as pelvic tilts, leaning forward, and the forward-leaning inversion that you can learn all about and how to do them in this video that I'm linking right up here. And then the last way to help manage lightning crotch is to make sure that you are getting adequate amounts of magnesium. Magnesium is an essential nutrient for our body in order for our muscular and our nervous system to work well, but most of us are not getting enough of it. So since lightning crotch has to do with your nerves, your muscles, and your ligaments, making sure that you're getting enough magnesium could potentially help a lot. So some foods that are very rich in magnesium are like dark leafy greens like spinach, kale, and other foods such as avocados, nuts, and even dark chocolate. And another great way to get magnesium, and my personal favorite, is taking baths with Epsom salt. And it's actually one of the best ways to help your body utilize that nutrient. So a couple times a week, treat yourself to a bath with about 2 cups of Epsom salt, and not only will it help you relax, but it might help your lightning crotch feel better too. So I'll link down below a pure Epsom salt that you can use so that you can enjoy yourself a nice self-care and healing bath. Okay, so hopefully that answers your question about a lightning crotch, but let's move on to our second question, how will I know I'm in labor? And before I answer this question, mamas who have had babies already, how did you know you were in labor? What were those telltale signs for you? If you're a first-time mama after this video, go check out those comments and see what some other mamas are saying about this question too. But to answer this question myself, you will know, mama. Now, one of the things you should know about labor if you don't already is that it's often a long process. And you can either look at that with dread or you can look at it from the perspective that labor gives you time to allow you to ease into it. Often as labor does begin and you start having some contractions, you might have to stop and think, maybe this is it. And not knowing for sure if you're in labor or not is actually beneficial for you. And that's because if you can ignore or at least distract yourself from the first bit of labor, your labor is going to feel so much shorter. So it's almost a blessing in disguise not knowing for absolute certainty if it is true labor from the very first contraction. But mama, you are going to know whether you are in labor when it really matters. When you notice your contractions are progressing in intensity and frequency, that's when you can be sure that it's not just Braxton Hicks or pre-labor symptoms anymore. Now, you still might have moments of doubt like, is this really it? But when you are needing to breathe through your surges that are now coming every like 5 minutes, you're going to know you're in labor and still have plenty of time before the arrival of your baby. So the bottom line for how you'll know if you're in labor is whether or not you are experiencing contractions that build in intensity and get closer together and longer in duration as time passes. And when you see those things all coming together, you know that you are really getting into the swing of labor. Now, the third question is, when should I be getting cervical exams during in labor, and what are the reasons for or against them? So cervical exams during labor allow you and your healthcare professional to know the progress of your labor. Typically, you're going to get one when you arrive, when you're in labor, in order to determine where you're at in the birth process and whether or not you should be admitted if you are giving birth at a hospital. And then while you're in labor, you might be checked a couple more times or not, depending on what you want. Some women want to know the progress of their cervix and others don't. I always encourage mamas by telling them that their bodies are going to do the work whether they know what is happening or not. And I also encourage them not to become too obsessed about dilation every time they get a cervical exam, because there's so many other important changes that are happening in the body that mark progress as well. So besides dilation, you're also looking for effacement and softening of your cervix, as well as the position of baby in your pelvis. And if you want to know other ways that your body and your baby prepares for birth, make sure you check out this video that I'm linking right up here for you. I also suggest to mamas who are trying to make decisions regarding the next steps of their birth process that might be thinking about Pitocin, or who are determining whether or not they want an epidural, or really any big decision for their birth, to get all the information that they can before making that call. And in order to get all of that information, it might mean for you to get a cervical exam. So for myself as an example, I got to a point in my own labor where I was so exhausted that I thought about getting an epidural. So I asked the nurse or the midwife to check me, and I was told that I was 7 centimeters dilated. And so based on that information and, you know, the knowledge that I brought into my birth experience with knowing that at 7 centimeters, I was about to go into transition and that could go quickly and I could push soon. So with that information, I decided not to get the epidural. And that was the right decision for me and my birth experience. But other women who are in the same scenario, are 7 centimeters dilated or whatever centimeters dilated, might choose to get the epidural because that's right for them and their birth. So whatever decision that you need to make, make sure that you have all the information, as well as, you know, where your cervix is and what it's doing, in order to decide what the next steps are for your birth. Now, if your bag of water has been released or broken, your baby is no longer protected by that amniotic sac barrier. So now there is more risk of infection with each cervical exam because every time fingers go up into the cervical area to check the progress, it also acts as an elevator ride for infection. And the last thing that you want is to increase the risk for infection. So when that's the case of your water already being released, you want to be very hesitant to have cervical checks, and your care provider will hopefully be very mindful of that as well. Typically, the rule of thumb for most births, whether your amniotic sac is intact or not, is to limit cervical exams until there is a significant change in mama's behavior that is marked by a change in her labor. So if, for example, your contractions are getting a lot closer together and they're now 2 minutes apart when they were like 5 minutes apart the last time you were checked, and you're having to be really focused and moan and sway through them, whereas before you just had to sit and be quiet, then it might be time to consider getting checked or not if it doesn't matter to you. If you're able to trust that your body is doing the work and your baby is going to be born eventually, then it's really up to you whether or not you want to have that cervical exam. Now, typically, when you say that you are starting to feel a lot of like rectal pressure, pressure in your bottom, like you need to poop, or you're feeling the urge to push, your nurse, doctor, or midwife will offer to do a cervical exam to see if pushing can be done safely, which is when you are 10 centimeters dilated. And that last cervical exam is the best one because that's when you get to hear you're complete and you're ready to push and that you are that much closer to meeting your perfect little baby. So as far as cervical exams go during labor, it's really up to you to see your progress, or if you don't really want to know because, you know, it'll just be too overwhelming or it will maybe discourage you more than encourage you, it's really up to you when you want those cervical exams. Typically, what they are going to do is do one at the beginning and then do one at the end before you're ready to push. So that's the rundown of our questions about lightning crotch, how you'll know you're in labor, and cervical exams in labor. I hope your questions were answered, or if you know a mama friend who is on the hunt for answers, share this video with her so she can be empowered and informed as well. If you have more questions, like I'm sure you do, comment them down below and I will continue doing these videos with your guys' frequently asked questions. So thanks for being with me in this video and I will see you in the next one. Bye, mamas.